नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम्। नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, shrimahans, mahans, tanedar, kotari, visitors, viewers, sarvagnapita yajamans, kartas, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV and in all the adhinams, paduka mandirs, temples, universities of Kailasa, all over the universe. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. On this auspicious Guru Purnima day, as living representative of the unbroken oldest Guru Parampara from Paramashiva himself, I offer my devotion, integrity, respects, commitment to that Guru Parampara first. As living representative of that parampara, I bless you all with all the auspiciousness and enlightenment. Some of the greatest sacred secrets of Paramashiva's existence, understand, by knowing these great sacred secrets, truths about the existence of Paramashiva, you will become Paramashiva. Paramashiva, the cosmic existence, can be experienced just by listening and internalizing these sacred secrets, powerful truths I am revealing. So please listen intensely and carefully. Akshaya Guna of Paramashiva means Guna can be, Guna means the nature, character, idea, habit, all these put together. And something more is the word, Sanskrit word Guna denotes, which is your core nature expresses as a habit in your doings. nature in your being, habits in your doing is called guna. Actually, the word Sanskrit word guna means little more than all these English definitions I gave. Character of your being, habits of your doing, all put together and something more is guna, nature. Akshaya guna means the nature of something which does not get destroyed. The Akshaya guna of Paramashiva, which does not get destroyed. Please listen. The guna of Paramashiva, which does not get destroyed, the nature of Paramashiva, which never gets destroyed. If you understand that, that nature is so exciting, inspiring, your whole being will just get sucked into it. It is like pi in mathematics. Pi in mathematics. I don't know how many of you have studied this concept of pi. It is such inspiring. Brain candy. That's the right word. Brain candy. If you are a superficial, stupid, rational, middle class mentality fellow, it will be maddening. The concept of pi will be maddening. But if you are really looking at life, understand, middle class has nothing to do with the bank balance you have. Middle class has something to do with intensity balance you have. Intensity with which you are ready to exist. That defines whether you are upper class or middle class. There are so many lives with all the luxuries but continues to remain middle class, lower middle class. There are some who lived throughout their life in jungles but lived such upper class life like great rishis, Janaka. Janaka spent some time as king, but quite a long time he spent in forest. Many of the rishis spent a lot of time in the forest alone, but the intensity with which they existed, the very class of their existence was different. Understand, this concept of pi is extremely maddening. Rationality of irrationality. Logic of beyond logic. Circumference of the sun or the circle of your DNA helix structure. Are the circle of your eyeball, all of them have some
inexplicable. Connection that exists irrationally rational, illogically logical, things which does not have any common factor are all interconnected and functions as a huge organism and rhythm in Vedantic principles. In Sanatana Hindu Dharma, we say Drishti Srishti. Understand? If you open your eyes wide, somewhere in the cosmos, the circumference of the sun is becoming bigger. I know. What I am talking is logically maddening. And just if you take out this clip and put it in Avatar clicks, it will become viral. This is the material ready for viral. But what I am talking is the truth. Please listen. If you open your eyes widely, somewhere in the cosmos, one sun, its circumference is increasing. It's reality. This is called Drishti Srishti. Maddening concept for mathematical brain is pi, pi concept. Understand the maddening irrationality. Of existence can become your experience with a simple non-violent listening. Just come to non-violent listening. Relax from the aggression going on inside. Trying to vomit the frustration of your guts into every happening in your life. Stop it. And listen intensely. These truths can put you in samadhi, in the space of Paramashiva now. Just like the concept of pi in the field of mathematics. How? Everything irrational has some rational flow. Paramashiva's guna. Everything irrational has some rational. So the essence of today's satsang is Paramashiva's pi. Pi of Paramashiva. Listen intensely. What I am talking is the direct download. From Paramashiva directly and mapped to the language you can grasp. I also request all of you to watch this satsang at least 21 times again and again and again, because Everything I am going to reveal, each statement is like a sutra. Guna means something which is core nature. Akshaya guna means something which is core nature, which can never be destroyed or separated from the existence of that core. Akshaya guna of Paramashiva. Paramashiva neither as guna nor nirguna. He is akshaya guna. He is neither with attributes nor attribute less. He is with some attributes which can never be attributed or withdrawn or destroyed. Right. So listen carefully. The Akshaya Guna, Pai of Paramashiva. I cannot use the word exactly, Pai of Paramashiva. Like Pai in maths, the Akshaya Guna of Paramashiva. Each of the powerful cognitions Vedas, Agamas reveal, which I have distilled and shared with you all in the form of Jnana Paddhati, Nityananda Jnana Paddhati. Each of those powerful cognitions are a Pai of Paramashiva. Listen, if you apply them in your being, immediately, Kailasa opens to you. You open Kailasa in you and Kailasa opens itself for you. Understand? Your body is an organism. The fuel for this organism is whatever you consider as truth of your existence. If you consider truth of your existence is nothing but struggling, fighting, suffering, no one can liberate you. Understand? If you consider the existence of you, if you strongly believe the core of you, or the truth of you and truth of your reality, truth of your life, truth of your existence is suffering, torture, pain, frustration, nobody can save. The good news I have for you is you can change that cognitions because they are delusion. You also know they are delusion. Unfortunately, as a child, you are always supported, pampered when you throw tantrum. That becomes such a strong pattern in you. You continue to throw tantrum till you are dead. Sometimes even after that. I have seen some people, even after death, they throw tantrum. Understand? Existence is a mirror. It does not pamper you when you throw tantrum. Your parents pamper you when you throw tantrum, not because they care, just they want to escape from you and they can't handle. Understand? throwing tantrum and getting what you want, you are not getting because you are qualified. Even if you get, when you throw tantrum and you don't get, it is good for you because you will not develop that pattern as your core belief, akshaya guna. If you throw tantrum and you get it, that's the worst thing for you because you will develop that as a akshaya guna, dangerous. Belief, if I throw tantrum, if I behave victim, if I do stupid dramas, I will get what I want. That belief is the worst akshaya guna, worst cognition. If you throw tantrum and get what you want, you are dead, you are destroyed. Parents, a good parent will not give what child wants when the child throws tantrum, because then the child is going to destroy herself. But the parents who don't want to spend time and bring up, who don't want to take the responsibility for the child, they give what child wants when the child throws tantrum, and the child develops the worst pattern. I tell you, in the Rajavidya Gurukuls, the Gurukuls where kings and queens, prince and princesses are brought up, they should be taught delayed gratification, not getting when they throw tantrum. When they throw tantrum, they need a strong punishment. Prayaschitta. In my Rajavidya Gurukuls, this should be the principle. Understand? The human beings develop this pattern throwing tantrum and getting what they want. That pattern evolves as the worst poisonous being. You continue to believe your life is a frustration. That idea of victimhood. Constantly you believe your life is a curse, and all the powerlessness becomes your akshaya guna, which is the dangerous thing. I tell you, every powerless cognition you remove as your akshaya guna and add powerful cognitions into your akshaya guna is a blessing for you. Multiple powerless cognitions becomes your core belief, unfortunately, from the young age due to unconscious, irresponsible ecosystem, not just parents, everyone, teachers, students, ecosystem. Again and again, whenever I remember, my eyes became watery about the ecosystem of Arunachala. Every dust in Arunachala hill, every dust in that Arunachala village, I bow down to it. Pranamami muhurmuhu. Pranamami muhurmuhu. The ecosystem
which Arunagiri Yogeshwara manifested. I tell you, even my health, I am 41. I am so confident I am going to live at least next 200 years. It is just because the ecosystem of Arunachala taught me right eating. Not only I never tasted non-veg, never had interest, I did not even need to fight or control myself to be away from non-vegetarian food. Understand? See, non-vegetarian is not just a food. It is a culture, core beliefs you have. Somebody who eats non-vegetarian food, meat, cannot love a pet. Understand? It is a hypocrisy. What? You will kill a calf and cow and bull and eat, but you will caress the dog? It is the core beliefs. Because never tasted non-veg, never had interest, never even need to fight to be vegetarian. By its own nature, the core cognition, akshaya guna, became ahimsa, non-violent way of existence. It is not just about tongue, it is about the cognition, core of what you are. See, if something becomes your food, beautifully, one of the great saint, Thiruvalluvar, he says, how can a man who eats meat have compassion in his life? If somebody does not eat meat, whole universe will worship him as compassionate being. Understand? It may be very simple thing for many people. What is there vegetarian food now? So many people are practicing veganism, vegetarian life. Understand, being vegetarian, vegan for right reasons from the ecosystem. Please listen.
Kollanai pulalai maruttanai kaikoopi ella uyirundolum kollan pulalai maruttanai kaikoopi ella uyirundolum means if somebody does not kill and does not eat meat, all the beings will worship him. Listen, it is not just about veganism, vegetarian life. It is the cognitions you carry in your core. For example, a person who is vegetarian with the right core cognitions, akshaya guna. If a goat is hurt in the street, he will have water in his eyes, not water in his tongue. If a goat is hurt in the street, man who is vegetarian from his core principle, akshaya guna, will have water in the eyes, not in the mouth, not in the tongue. understand the fundamental principles. Fundamental principles of life. Core beliefs you carry is too important for your existence. The core beliefs you carry manifest as life, because that is the pi of your personal, individual existence manifests and projects as your reality. If you bring the pi of Paramashiva into your core existence, you become Paramashiva. You manifest the life as Paramashiva. Understand? My whole effort is the organism called your body, removing all the powerless cognitions and adding all the powerful cognitions to your core existence, to your core belief about you. Understand, I tell you. The good news I have is, consciously, if you decide, even unconscious powerless cognitions loses power over you. I tell you, I'll expand. Listen. I'll tell you one incident from my life with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, my own guru. This very principle which I am talking to all of you, the Akshaya Guna of existence, Paramashiva, he was trying to explain from a different context, from a different reason. He was trying to explain the truth of Drishti Srishti, how every thought we create manifests as life, and how careful and alive, awake we should be about thought. So, right thing manifests as life. I was sitting next to him and he was teaching me this principle about Drishti Srishti, how the way we see the existence, the reality changes. I'll describe the scene. He was sitting on the steps in Arunachaleshwara temple in Kalyana Mandapam, near his Jiva Samadhi. I was sitting a step below him and holding his thumb, his feet. He was explaining he was such an extremely beautiful being. He's a feast for all five senses. The smell around him and the way he captures the whole eyes. Both eyes will be sucked into him. Automatically, third eye need to be opened to be there. By his very beauty, స్వరూప దర్శన మాత్ర హీ ఓపెన్స్ ఓపెన్స్ ఆల్ థర్డ్ ఐస్ బికాస్ టు ఐ విల్ నాట్ బి సఫిషియంట్ యువర్ హోల్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ విల్ ఫీల్ ఇన్సఫిషియంట్ ఇన్ఎఫిషియంట్ టు గ్రాస్ప్ హిస్ ఫామ్ ఆటోమేటికలీ యువర్ థర్డ్ ఐ విల్ ఓపెన్ యూ విల్ బి సో అబ్జార్బ్డ్ ఇన్ హిమ్ ఫీస్ట్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ద ఫైవ్ సెన్సెస్ Even if I touch him, I have seen my mouth will become watery. The whole saliva is such tasty, delicious being even to touch. Just by touch, I have seen. If I touch him by hand, my mouth will feel the deliciousness. That kind of a being. He was describing this, how the thought becomes reality. How every thought we have, we believe, changes the universe. I tell you, even now, I literally believe, really, really, Meenakshi happened. She walked on planet Earth and did all the leelas described in the Purana. Not some metaphysical, metaphorical thing is described as a poetry in the Purana. No. Real factual history. Puranas actually record very less, which you can understand. No, if they record the whole thing, you may not even be able to grasp it. Destruction of the third eye science in India made common Indians believe Puranas are not real. Just if I awaken the third eye to one generation kids, of course I'm going to do it. If I just work on the third eye, and if even 10 million kids fully third eye awakened and start perceiving the reality in a higher level, they will start understanding Puranas are real. How the Tiruvaliyar Puranam says that Sundareshwara used to just walk out of the Garbhagriha and come and do all the leelas. கல்யாணைக்கு கரும்பூட்டி கிழவனை குமரனாக்கி ஆனை பெண்ணாக்கி பெண்ணை ஆணாக்கி அலியை ஊனாக்கி உன்னை நானாக்கி என்னை நீயாக்கி பிளேயிங் ஆல் தோஸ் லீலாஸ் வாட் எவர் இஸ் ரிட்டன் இன் த புராணாஸ் ஆர் ரியலி ரியல் இட் ஹேப்பன்ட் அண்ட் ஸ்டில் ஹேப்பனிங் This becomes my core cognition, truth of existence. Just by darshan of Arunagiri Yogeshwara, he made the higher reality as my core belief, akshaya guna of me, by his darshan. Guru is a person who makes all the higher existence, higher possibility as your core belief reality. Kailasa as your Chidambara. Kailasa as your Chidambara, inner space, heart. Whatever is the reality of the Kailasa, in Kailasa, what all the beliefs are core reality, core concept truths, akshaya guna, imperishable truths of Kailasa, becoming your core truths, is purpose of my advent. I happened for that. What whatever is believed, whatever is cognized as the core reality in Kailasa, I am bringing them as powerful cognitions for all of you to experience that as your core belief, Akshaya Guna, core existence. Arunagiri Yogeshwara was teaching. Suddenly there was an ant moving from my hand to his feet. And I became very protective of Arunagiri Yogeshwara and wanted to kill that ant. Before I could move my hand and kill it, he just beautifully took it from his hand and left it. And that ant, after tasting his hand, I think fulfilled, and it had a darshan and sparshan and started moving. Then suddenly I had the thought, oh God, just now he was teaching every thought need to be right. And now I manifested, now I had the wrong thought. Will that manifest as a wrong effect in my life? The moment I had this thought, he started smiling. And I asked, Swami, and by now I know that he knows whatever I think, he knows. So I did not explain the whole thing. I just, Swami means, I am asking you answer now. The thought I had, the question I had now, please answer. For that, I was looking at him just through eyes questioning, Swami. He laughed and showed the finger like that. Means his energy field, all the thoughts appeared in me, just got dissolved. It will not have any negative ripple effect because of his energy field. Neither I asked the question verbally, I just asked through. Eyes. And uttered the word, Swami. I had a different kind of relationship with him. Only when there is a spiritual talk, I will relate with him like a Swami, means Guru, God. Such extraordinary friendliness he radiated and love he gave. And I asked him once the boon. Let me enjoy your friendliness without taking you for granted, forever being integrated to you, committed to you. And he gave me that boon. Because of that extreme friendliness, he was my father, mother, uncle, everything. Once I brought a dhoti from home and gave it to him. This giving habit was taught to me by my father and mother. The extraordinary givers, for their wealth, the way they gave is unimaginable. Even though people who live around me feel that I am a giver, but nothing compared to my father. Very irresponsible giver. Even in giving, irresponsible giving. Whenever he buys a dhoti for himself, he will always get a kavi dhoti for me. for me to give it to sadhus, because he knows otherwise his white dhoti will be taken away. One day I took white dhoti, even though there was a kavi dhoti, I took a white dhoti for Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I gave it away. My mother asked, to whom you gave it? For whom you took? I did not answer. I wanted to find out first from Arunagiri Yogeshwara and then come back and tell whether I can reveal I gave it to him. So I did not answer, I just walked out. Directly went to him and said, my mother is asking like that, what should I answer? He said in Tamil, Vannanu kuduthan sollu po. Means, go and tell your mom that you gave it to her brother, elder brother. But she doesn't have elder brother. She has cousin brother, elder brother, only younger brother, three brothers. I did not remember all that. I just know, whatever he says, let me go and tell. I went and told her that I gave it to your elder brother. She did not tell anything. I was surprised. Because from my knowledge, I don't know that she has elder brother. Later on I came to know she has a cousin brother, elder brother, and whose house is between the house I was born and brought up and the temple. So, it just matched. Maybe that is the reason she just kept quiet. But for me it was such juicy thing. I said, if you are elder brother of my mother, then you are my mama. He said, yes, yes, I am your Thai mama. I had extreme friendliness. All relationships, all possible relationships with him. Core beliefs he planted inside me, the powerful cognitions, the akshaya guna of me, is the direct akshaya gunas of Paramashiva. And that ecosystem of Arunachala supported it. This whole Kailasas I am building all over the world is nothing but my energy field. So, even if you have negative thoughts, it will die down. It will not create negative impact and ripple effects inside you, for you or for others. Understand? For example, if you live in our Kailasas and live the vegetarian lifestyle, even unconsciously, mentally, you get sometime these negative thoughts, violent thoughts, it will just die down, it will not create any ripple effects, it will not create bad effects for you and for the world. That is the purpose of this Kailasas. In every level, whether the level of Brahmacharya or the level of every vow, every ahimsa, satya, asteya, aparigraha, in all levels, understand the cognitions you carry manifest as reality in your life. Powerful cognitions are pi of Paramashiva. The moment you insert them, powers manifest. I tell you, simple, straightforward words. just decide to cognize the powerful cognitions so many powerful cognitions Paramashiva as I pi pi Paramashiva as I is pi of Paramashiva. This is the powerful cognitions. When you carry, when you put this powerful cognitions inside you, like you are Paramashiva, whatever may be the external, internal situations of you. This is one of the powerful cognition. Whatever denies this powerful cognition, decide, sit and pen down, do completion with it. Or do dash, dash, dash with it. You feel that all bad words in the dash, dash, dash. Because all completion is nothing but actually, if you really behave like my disciple, when you look at your completion, in many Western countries, I have seen that when you are driving, if you honk, the other person will do something. They will lower the glass and raise the hand and show and go. I never understood that because that was never part of this Indian. In India, honking is a lifestyle. Every vehicle they will write, sound horn. You are expected to honk. It is encouraged. The West, honking is not. Western countries, honking is not culture. And if you honk, they will lower the glass. And first time when I saw that, I could not understand. I was asking the devotee who was driving me, what is this? What is going on? He said, it is a bad word, Swamiji. Actually, you should do that to all your completion. When you see your incompletions, you should just do that same showing the finger to all your incompletions. Now all of you know it, what I am saying. Show finger to your incompletions. Be ferocious with it. I tell you. I'll give you one important secret. All insecurity. Visualize all insecurity and pour it on Kalabhairava. Decide to stand and face. Let your insecurities physically melt your muscles and stand. You will see that insecurity just destroys you. Stand as Paramashiva. Insecurities are the acid poured on your system. Stand tall. Along with your toxins, the insecurities will leave you. Stand as Paramashiva. Man who stands in front of the insecurities becomes Paramashiva. Your body is like a mechanism. Because your consciousness is inside, it is organism. That consciousness is suffering with the wrong cognitions as your reality. You started believing wrong things as the core beliefs of your existence, Akshaya Guna. You just need to remove them. Put the right cognitions. I have given thousands of powerful cognitions. For example, this one. Static matter
dynamic, activity, strategic existence, all three are one and the same. There is no border, boundary. If you just cognize, whatever comes as opposition to this core truth is an incompletion. Either complete them or burn them or be ferocious with it or show finger to it. Show finger to your incompletions. You know which finger. I don't have to show. But burn them. Burn them. Burn them. Even if you decide consciously, I will stick to this powerful cognition. Even if the powerless cognitions come in between, I am not going to bend for it. I am going to stand with this powerful cognition. You will see that powerful cognitions just starts manifesting as powers and enlightenment. That decision is called commitment to Guru. My commitment to Arunagiri Yogeshwara is the only thing that made everything possible for me. Whenever any problem arises, no, I committed to him. So let's just do that. That's all. There is no second thing. I committed to him. So let's do it. That's all. That is the real finger to the incompletions. The real finger you need to show to your incompletion is, I committed to my guru to live powerfully. I committed different cognitions to him, so I cannot live with you. Pai of Paramashiva. I tell you, every powerful cognition is Akshaya Guna of Paramashiva. Bring them into you, all the other things not integrated to that powerful cognitions either pin down and burn or complete, relive and relieve or show fingers. I don't care, but get rid of them. I still remember first time when a devotee was driving me, it was that long car, I forgot the name, to receive you, they bring, I forgot the name of that car, it was in limousine, car they brought, and then I always sit in the front seat, next to the driver. They said, no, Swamiji, this is a VIP car, you are supposed to sit in the back side. I saw all the glasses and all that. I said, what is the use of all these for me? I don't. 90% of the world has no use for me. Only little food and the cloth and this few jewelry which I am wearing, only this is useful for me from the world. Otherwise, I have no relationship with this world. So, actually once they took me to the world's biggest mall in Toronto, I think. That owner was a devotee, so he said, please come and bless. And they took me around and then finally they said, what do you want? I said, nothing here is useful for me. Nothing here is related to my life. He was shocked. Swamiji, we brag that anyone comes here always buys and buys more than what they need and go on. I said, I have nothing to do sitting backside. I'll sit in the front. At least I can see the road. Because the village boys, the maximum pleasure for us is sitting in the car and lowering the glass and seeing through the window. That is the maximum pleasure in the life. Nothing. Simple pleasured people are the richest people in the world. Simple pleasured means always happy.
simple things are enough to make you happy. And so I said, no, I am going to sit in the front. They said, no, Swamiji, as per the tradition that only the staff sit in the front in this kind of a big car. I said, no, I am going to sit here only. Anyhow, I sat. When they were driving, by mistake, this driver put the hand on the horn and honked. That is when I saw that person, somebody driving in the road, lowered the glass and raised the hand and showed the finger. I could not understand why. But I understood that something is wrong. That much I understood. Because the face expression. Then the devotee explained. Understand. The yoga danda I received from Arunagiri Yogeshwara, which has protected me and still protecting me from everything, is I committed to him. I'm going to do it. That's all. I committed to Swamiji, so I'm going to do it. That's all. There is no second thought. That became my core cognition. I tell you, the biggest gift he gave me, when he stopped appearing physically to me and stopped being physically available, the greatest gift he gave me is, of course, oneness. That is one. The greatest gift is that core cognition. I committed to him, so I am going to do it. All insecurities, nothing could ever stop me or touch. By and by, they stopped even talking to me. The insecurities have started feeling, oh, nothing can be done with this fellow. So they divorced me and went away. Because there is no engagement, there is no entertainment. I just started telling, I committed to Swamiji, so I am going to do it. Every time, bring the powerful cognitions inside. Still, I am not yet done. I'm going to talk next 2-3 hours. I have a lot to share, a lot to talk to all of you, a lot to tell you all. For quite a long time, I have too much downloaded. So I have to talk to you all a lot of things. And now whenever incompletions are coming, you guys are going to remember the finger. You guys are only going to remember. Swamiji told, show finger. So any incompletion comes, just show finger, that's all. Maybe we can have a very decent Sanskrit name for it. Nadumiduna Mudra. Nobody can call this as a bad word. Show Nadumiduna Mudra. When your finger incompletions come to you. We have a lot of names for different mudras. So we can call this as a Nadumiduna Mudra. Understand, fundamentally, your incompletions are not even worthy of sitting and completing. It's only worthy of Nadumiduna Mudra. Otherwise, they will do that to you and to your life. Before they do, you do it to them. So you are safe. Be ferocious with incompletions. The existence
ferociously, standing tall in front of the insecurities and incompletions.
I tell you, really I tell you, life is all about standing tall. That is what I learned from Arunagiri Yogeshwara. Stand tall in front of any incompletions. I tell you, whenever you stand tall in front of your incompletions and ferociously you start romancing with powerful cognitions, understand, this powerful cognitions will manifest as powers in you intensely. Existing with powerlessness, you will feel everyone is out there to cheat you and exploit you. Understand, I never ever felt somebody is cheating me or exploiting me. I only always felt they are exploiting themselves. Thinking they are cheating me, they are cheating themselves. And their existence. So even when I say you are cheating me, I am uttering the word you are cheating you, thinking you are cheating me. Even when I accuse you, it is out of my compassion to you. It is not accusation, it is awakening. Understand, whether you are in the Kailasa or outside the Kailasa, or in the outer world, wherever you are, life is the effect, manifestation of your core beliefs, your core cognitions. Bring the pie of Paramashiva into your core belief. The Akshaya Guna of Paramashiva, let it become your core beliefs about you and your life and your existence. You will manifest enlightenment and powers and that kind of a life around you. Suffocation of your core beliefs about you and life is depression and frustration. Joy of your core beliefs and life is power and enlightenment. The one seed Arunagiri Yogeshwara has put in me is real. Paramashiva is real. I tell you guys, really I tell you guys, you are my disciple. With all my love, I tell you guys, the best thing I received from my guru, I am giving you guys as a prasada. This too is the best thing I received from my guru. One, my guru is real. Second, I committed to him. I will live like that. Over, that's all. Show your finger, Natumaidana Mudra, for everything else. All insecurity,
patterns, incompletions, everything. And I tell you, you will always be successful. I am real. My words are real. It's my blessing to all of you. Ferocious blessing. Blessing enforced on you. A ferocious blessing. I give you the ferocious blessings. My disciples always win, succeed. The ecosystem of Thiruvannamalai gave me competence to live, not stupid any qualifications. Qualifications can be an introduction. When you talk about you to others, when you try to sell, qualification is like that gift wrapper, how they wrap it up with a jig 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 paper. It can be gift wrapper. Competence is the real gift inside the wrapper. These powerful cognitions made me competent for life. Arunagiri Yogeshwara is such embodiment of that powerful cognition. I tell you, when I touch him by the hand, I used to feel that sweetness and that kick in the tongue. Just touching him by the hand, I just sat. Even now when I remember, my eyes can experience that kick. My tongue can taste that sweet. His form can be smelt by the nose and heard by the ears. His voice can be seen by the eyes and smelt by the nose and tasted by the tongue. His everything can be enjoyed by all five senses and more. Just the whole kundalini will become alive. I remember still when he blessed that Jiva Samadhi in Thiruvannamalai, in our Kailasa in Thiruvannamalai, Adi Annamalai. Vanni Perunjudarai எழுந்தருளிய நாம் வன்னி மூலையில் வன்னி மரத்தில் இவ்வன்னி மர வடிவாய் என்றென்றும் இங்கிருந்தருளி எல்லோர்க்கும் அருள் செய்வோம். As a light shaft, I came in this Agni corner, and as the Agni tree, Vanni tree, I will stand and reside and bless all of you forever in this tree and under this tree. Somebody who loves me most, whom I love most, before I leave the body, if they ask me, Swamiji, just give essence of your whole life so that we can carry for future. We can write this as a golden words and keep it for future. I'll tell you just these few words. Personal intimate attachment to Guru for everything else. Everything else is an incompletion. How it should be treated, you know, I already taught you. Madhya Maithuna Mudra. Sanskrit word gives a very decent spiritual look. If I tell in English only, it will become a viral video. So I told Sanskrit, Madhya Maithuna Mudra. See, all of you do Anganyasa Karanyasa. You know the fingers name. Angushtabhyam Namaha Darjani Ibhyam Swaha Madhyam Abhyam Vashat Anamika Abhyam Hum
కనిష్టాభ్యాం ఔషధ. సో యు నో అంగన్యాస కరణ్యాస మంత్ర. Everything else is in completion. Understand? Everything great expressed in me just when I remembered my personal intimate attachment, Ra, my connection with my Guru Arunagiri Yogeshwara, is real. Just let me remember his name, his form, and him, and be attached to him forever, ever, ever, in all the raw ways, not socially decent or socially polite, absolute oneness with him. That's all is the essence of my life. Everything else, you don't know what to do. Whenever I carried this cognizance, Paramashiva just exploded through me, manifesting all the best things. My attachment to my Guru destroyed all other attachments. And finally, made oneness. Still in my computer screen, in Facebook, some Arunachala's photo come, I'll stop everything and sit and bow down and connect like a school kid. There may be, these guys may be giving me some big legal update, and the update's about so many things happening. I'll say, wait. That is the essence and juice of my life, my attachment to my Guru, Arunagiri Yogeshwara. If I look, what is the essence of my life? My personal attachment to my Guru, that's all. All the best things in my life, I received only from that. I don't even want to use the word Guru Bhakti. That looks too big and Vedanti. I don't want to use the word Guru Bhakti. I want to use the word Guru Pasam. That's all. Without even knowing what is integrity, I enjoyed integrity with him. Without even knowing what is responsibility, I enjoyed responsibility for him. Without even knowing what is enriching, I was enriching about him to the world. Without even knowing what is Brahman, I had Brahman Jnana from him. Before even knowing the word Brahman, he gave me Brahman Jnana. Actually, I learnt the words much later. Words I learnt only to cross verify and to tell you all. I don't know how many of you know, in Tiruvannamalai for the Arunagiri Yogeshwara's Jiva Samadhi, the Stapadi carved my deity little bigger than that Arunagiri Yogeshwara's deity. I said, no, it will not be installed. I rejected my deity. It was perfect, but I rejected. No, make smaller than Arunagiri Yogeshwara. Actually, I was not building the Arunagiri Yogeshwara's Jiva Samadhi inside our Adhinam, because I didn't want a second Jiva Samadhi. Then finally, now I am forced to build, because I wanted to see that always through web camera, to have darshan. Inside the temple, they may not allow. That is the reason I built it, so I can keep a web camera and continuously have darshan. Raw attachment, pasa as per agama, not bhakti as per Vedanta. I am not interested in that. I am interested in raw attachment with my guru and raw obedience. I don't need a logic. I don't need to be convinced to obey my guru. I just know he is real and I am attached to him. I am committed to him. I will do it. That's all. Too simple. And life is too easy, too beautiful. And too exciting, too inspiring. Continuously enlightening, successful. Wherever I obeyed my gurus, I was successful. You can all have darshana parunagiri yogi ishwara. Pai of Paramashiva. Akshaya Guna of Paramashiva. Carrying which you will become Paramashiva is this powerful cognizance which I have revealed in thousands and continuing to reveal. Understand? All these powerful cognitions. Paramashiva is real. Unclutching gives you the experience of the Paramashiva state. Integrity makes you experience the space of Paramashiva. Enriching will make you manifest powers. All these powerful cognitions. I have given thousands. Still I am giving thousands more. I have compiled all these powerful cognitions from Vedas and Agamas as a Nityananda Jnana Paddhati, and it is available freely. I will tell them to share today. Nityananda Jnana Paddhati. Understand these powerful cognitions. When you keep them inside, be ferocious with all other incompletions. They will just manifest as powers. I tell you, fundamental things, fundamental basic truths, if you start practicing them, it's called initial. If you apply them again and again and again in your life, it is called advanced. That's all. You become an advanced person if you manifest it again and again and again in you. That's it. Fundamentals don't change. If you apply the fundamental setup may change. Fundamentals don't change. This funda-making mental setup changes. I'll come to the subject straight after 1.5 hours. Listen. I'll give you now few cognitions. One. Paramashiva is real. He came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara. He initiated me and gave enlightenment and himself in oneness to me. And I am giving you that blessing. One, Paramashiva is real. He himself came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and initiated me, blessed me and gave me the oneness. That's second cognition. Third, I am giving you that same blessing and experience to all of you. I am not putting the precondition here. Please be very clear. I am not saying, if you are integrated to me like how I was integrated to Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I am giving you this experience. No. I am saying directly, I am giving you this experience. Actually, when you start experiencing and start manifesting powers, you will become integrated like how I was with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. See, I am practical. I enjoyed him, so I fell in love with him. I don't know good or bad reasons. Many of you not even seen me physically. One generation of devotees have come who has not seen me physically. Maybe it is a new to Nityananda Sangha, but that generation has started. Usually this happens only when the masters leave the body. But I am the first master living in the body. One generation of devotees are already built who has not seen me physically. And not devotees, one generation of Adinavasis, Kailasavasis, who have given their life, who have taken sannyas, never seen me physically. A batch of Gurukul kids, Balasans, who have given their whole life to me, who has not seen me physically. Even if you people who have seen me physically, very many may not have touched me. How I touched and experienced Arunagiri Yogeshwara. So I am not putting this integrity as a prerequisite. Just this three cognition. One, Paramashiva is real. Paramashiva came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and initiated, gave enlightenment, oneness and powers to Swamiji. And Swamiji is giving all of that blessing, energy, oneness, experience to me. Just carry this three cognition and sit now. I will make Guru Diksha happen in you all. I'll just open this thunder of Paramashiva. Let thunder of Paramashiva land on planet Earth and bless all of you. Let Paramashiva land and bless all of you. Bless all of us. Bless every one of us. Just this three simple cognition. I'll repeat. Paramashiva is real. He himself came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and gave oneness to, oneness and experience all every himself to Swamiji. And Swamiji is giving that to me now. See, I am telling you, I am giving. I am not putting any condition. I am giving. Just sit with these three cognitions inside you. All the incompletions which is coming, which is not ready to accept these three cognitions, you know what to do. Madhya, Maituna, Mudra. Let those incompletions be ferociously dealt. They are not going to give you any life. So, kick them out. Kick them out of your life before they kick you out from Guru's space. Kick your patterns out before they kick you out of Kailasa. Understand? Just sit with these three cognitions. Pin down these three cognitions. And any thought currents which is not allowing you to accept these three cognitions, pin down. I'll give you a few minutes. So that you are very clear inside you. And you can hold the pie of Paramashiva inside and let all the patterns be given the Madhya Maituna Mudra. It is going to become viral now, I know. Without uttering a bad word. Throw away, deal ferociously your incompletions. So, pick up a paper and pen, write these three powerful cognitions you are supposed to hold inside you. One, Paramashiva is real. Second, Paramashiva himself came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and gave himself to Swamiji, giving estate, space, powers, being, super consciousness, oneness, himself to Swamiji. And Swamiji is giving that to me now. Just these three cognitions, pen down, 1, 2, 3. And then if you have any thought currents, incompletions, which is not allowing that to be cognized by you as your reality, pen them down. So you can do the Madhya Maituna Mudra to those incompletions. In Tamil I said Natu Maituna Mudra. In Sanskrit Madhya Maituna Mudra. Chancha chancha chan. It's going to become very popular now. You can do that to all those incompletions. Take few minutes, pen down. Then I'll start the Guru Diksha. I'll make sure today Paramashiva lands on all of us and blesses all of us and creates Kailasas all around the world, celebrates the whole existence.
Addendum. Now, as all of us are preparing to receive the best Diksha, the most auspicious initiation on this auspicious day of Guru Purnima, let us all take a few minutes and say our yes to receive this initiation. All those who are ready, waiting to receive this initiation on this auspicious day, we kindly request you to go to the link that is projected and place your comment as you request to have this initiation of Guru Diksha. Just want to share this again. It's only upon the request of a disciple, Guru can enter your being and give you the experience of the initiation. Anybody who is interested, waiting to receive this most auspicious Diksha, the initiation of Guru Diksha, on this auspicious day of Guru Purnima, we request you to give your consent by placing your comment. The post, the link is projected on your screen now.
Yes, we'll start the initiation. Please sit straight. Just declare to the cosmos with your whole being. Declare to the cosmos, Paramashiva is real. Means universal existence is intelligence. Intelligent, alive universe is what I call Paramashiva. Paramashiva is real. And he himself came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and gave himself to Swamiji. And now, Swamiji is giving that to all of us. Let Paramashiva land on all of us and express state, space, powers,
being and super consciousness and explode. Declare to yourself and to the universe, Paramashiva is real. Paramashiva is manifesting here as my Guru Nityananda Paramashivam and manifesting himself in all of us, in each one of you. Hold this powerful cognition. Sit. Chant the Mahavagya intensely, internally. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva intensely land on all of us. Let Paramashiva explode in all of us. Let the state, space, powers, being and super consciousness of Paramashiva manifest in all of us. Let Guru Diksha happen in all of us. Chant the Mahavagya intensely. Let Paramashiva manifest in all of us. Let the state, space, powers, being and super consciousness of Paramashiva manifest in all of us. Listen carefully. Now, whether you know it or not, accept it or not, listen or not, believe it or not, I have initiated all of you. Paramashiva has initiated all of us. Just carry from today this simple precognition. Paramashiva is real. He himself came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara and gave himself to Swamiji. And Swamiji is directly giving himself to me. Just this three, that's all. And I tell you, to remind yourself about these three powerful cognitions. Just to remind you about these three powerful cognitions. day and night chant Mahavagya. Just these three powerful cognitions carry inside. Chant Mahavagya internally, Om Nityananda Parama Shivoham. From today, all of you carry these three simple powerful cognitions inside, and I am not asking you integrity like how I had with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. You see, I am not saying only if you have an integrity with me, how I had with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I will give you me. No, I am not saying that. I am telling you, hold this cognition, you will be showered. After that, integrity will happen automatically inside you. Because enriching is all about giving. I am here to enrich all of you. Giving, giving, giving. Automatically you will become integrated. When you start receiving from Paramashiva, automatically you will become integrated, authentic, responsible, enriching, all that. Understand? All of you, take this as a guru walk. This is the Guru Diksha. Have a small japamala like this in Rudraksha. Maybe 108 beats or 54 beats. Small Rudraksha mala. Have it in your hand 24 hours and go on, be chanting with japamala. Inside, internally, let Mahavagya roll. Externally, let the japamala roll in your hand. Why japamala? You know, so that you don't fall asleep. Even when I am resting in samadhi, the japamala will be rolling in my hand continuously. The people who take care of me, they have watched many times. If your japamala is rolling in your hand continuously, even while you are asleep, you are in samadhi. You are in ajapa japa. From today, all my disciples, just carry a small japamala in your hand. Just these three powerful cognitions. Paramashiva is real. He himself came and gave himself to my guru, Swamiji, Nityananda Paramashivam, and he is giving himself completely to me. So I am manifesting the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness of Paramashiva continuously with this cognition. Go on, be repeating Mahavagya, have this japamala with you. I tell you, you will have everything. All the best things of life. Including enlightenment. When he himself is showering, then when he himself is manifesting through you, naturally you are going to have everything. Understand? Just carry these three simple cognition inside, and all other incompletions, all other difficulties, just dump them. You know what should be done with them. Just dump them. Just be ferocious and complete all of it. Everything else is incompletion. Throw them out. Everything else is useless. Throw them out. Just these three powerful cognitions. Manifest. Chant the Mahavagya 24 hours with these three powerful cognitions inside. Let all other cognitions disappear, melt down. All other incompletions, everything else, let it melt down. Hold on to these three powerful cognitions. And do ajapa japa with the japamala. Japamala is useful so that you don't fall asleep or don't get diverted or deluded. I have seen the use of japamala. Arunagirinathar sings, Japamalai Tanda Gurunada. I have so much to tell. Just
chant this Mahavagya. I will continuously talk to you. I will continuously be connected to you. This satsang can only be started, can never be ended. I am introducing Kailasa to all of you. You see, the whole pie of Kailasa, the pie of Paramashiva, I am introducing. I am connecting that to all of you. This Mahavagya is pie of Paramashiva. When you are chanting, holding these three powerful cognitions, you will go on be manifesting state, space, powers, enlightenment, being, super consciousness of Paramashiva. There is so much to tell. Just flower your whole being with Mahavagya. Let Mahavagya blossom in your being. So I request and recommend all my disciples, devotees, followers to have Japamala in the hand 24 hours, 24/7. Go on be chanting Mahavagya, doing Ajapa Japa inside, carrying this and holding this powerful cognitions inside. Paramashiva is real. He himself came and gave oneness to Swamiji, and Swamiji is now giving oneness to me. Over. Just these three. And go on be chanting Mahavagya 24/7 with Japamala. It can be 54 beats or 108 beats of Rudraksha.